真佛宗西雅图雷藏寺同修准提佛母本尊法，恭迎真佛宗创办人无上法王根本传承上师圣尊莲生活佛，师母莲香上师，众人虔诚合掌，唱诵莲花童子心咒。
我们一起齐声问候师尊好师母好师尊师母新年快乐。 礼坛城，一拜根本传承上师及十方三世一切诸佛。Om Ah Hom。 二拜诸菩萨。Om Ah Hom。 三拜诸护法金刚 ，Om Ah Hom。 四平等于其所，恭请法王圣尊莲生活佛。 生法王座。 今晚是新丑年春节的第一个同修，也是正月初二迎财神的日子。
This is the second day of the lunar calendar.
我们今晚迎来大福金刚法王圣尊莲生活佛清明下徒雷藏寺，让我们以最热烈的掌声感谢法王圣尊莲生活佛在下着大雪的大年初二来给弟子们赐福。我们也祝愿师尊师母新春如意，健康平安，福寿双全，心想事成。
The wealth deity and to attract wealth and riches. So we are truly grateful that His Holiness still come to the temple despite of the heavy snow.
同修准提佛母本尊法开始观想真佛宗传承。
It is Cundi Buddha Mother.
南无阿弥陀佛，南无莲花童子，南无莲生活佛。
Visualize to Buddha Lineage, Namo Vairokana Buddha, Namo Buddha Lokana, Namo Padma Kumara, Namo Amitabha Buddha. Recite the Guru Mantra 7 times.
Om Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hom. 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 Om Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hom.
做四无量观，观想，右手边有。Visualize. Ancestors and relatives from the father's side on your right, from the mother's side on your left. Friends and teachers behind you. Enemies and karmic gratitudes in front of you. And all sentient beings around you, together practicing tantric dharma and ultimately attaining Buddhahood.
做精行受应.
Wake up call.
练清净咒及安土地真言.
Recite purification mantras and the deity mantra.
修多利修多利修摩利修摩利受哈. Om Vajradang Ha Ha Hom. Namo Samanto Modaran Om Duru Duru Devai Soha.
This is an invocation mantra.
Soha. Om Ah Hom Soha. Om Ah Hom Soha. Zong Dizi Yi Xing Feng Qing. Namo Hong Guan Shen Mian Jing Gang Shang Shi Lian Sheng Huo Fo. Namo Hong Guan Shen Mian Jing Gang Shang Shi Lian Sheng Huo Fo. Namo Hong Guan Shen Mian Jing Gang Shang Shi Lian Sheng Huo Fo. 同修祖尊，南无准提佛母。同修祖尊，南无。
The main deity of the group practice, Namo Cundi Buddha Mother. The main deity of the group practice, Namo Cundi Buddha Mother. Namo Vairokana Buddha at the center. Namo Akshobha Buddha to the east. Namo Amitabha Buddha to the west. Namo Ratnasambha Buddha south. Namo Amoghasiddhi Buddha to the north. Namo Sakyamuni Buddha. Namo Medicine Buddha. Namo Golden Mother of the Primordial Jade Pond. Namo Siddhikarbha Bodhisattva. Namo Padma Kumara. Namo Avalokitesvara Bodhisattva. Namo Manjushri Bodhisattva. Namo Maitreya Bodhisattva. Namo Vajrasattva. Namo Guru Padmasambhava. All Herukas, Dhammapalas, Dakinis, and Divinities, all Buddhas of the Ten Directions in the Three Times, all Bodhisattvas and Mahasattvas, Namo Mahaprasna Paramita. Great homage using visualization. First to Root Guru and all Buddhas. Visualize for prostration on the ground, release the mudra. Second to all Bodhisattvas. Visualize for prostration on the ground, release the mudra. Third to all Herukas and Dhamma protectors. Visualize for procession on the ground, release the mudra, fourth head bow. Great mandala offering, form the offering mudra, visualize the transformations of the offerings to become innumerable to fill the whole cosmic space. Make the offering above to the lineage root guru, all the lineage gurus, the main deity, Mahachundi, Buddha Mother, all Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Herukas, Dhammapalas, Dakinis, and Divinities, and below to all sentient beings.
We
set the offering verse and mantra, one meal rule, four continents and sun and moon, transforming the precious offerings for the Buddhas. May these wonders precious and merits purge our karma to all of our civilization.
Om Sava Tathagata Yidamu Gurudana Menchana Kang Liliye Dayami.
Visualize our lineage root guru, all the lineage gurus, Buddha jewel, Dhamma jewel, Sangha jewel, to form bright white light to empower us.
We set the mantra. Namo Guru Pe, Namo Buddha Ye, Namo Dhamma Ye, Namo Sangha Ye, Namo Guru Pe, Namo Buddha Ye, Namo Dhamma Ye, Namo Sangha Ye, Namo Guru Pe, Namo Buddha Ye, Namo Dhamma Ye, Namo Sangha Ye.
I'm a protection formed by Jaklap's mudra.
We
said Vajrapani mantra 7 times.
Om Borinanjali, Om Borinanjali, Om Borinanjali, Om Borinanjali, Om Borinanjali, Om Borinanjali, Om Borinanjali.
We say Haikin Guan Yin Sutra, first the invocation of the eight great Bodhisattvas.
Namo Mila Pusa Mohasa, Namo Sri Kong Tan Pusa Mohasa, Namo Pusin Pusa Mohasa, Namo Jin Gang So Pusa Mohasa, Namo Miao Ji Xian Pusa Mohasa, Namo Tsu Gai Zan Pusa Mohasa, Namo Di Zan Wang Pusa Mohasa, Namo Tsu Zun Pusa Mohasa, Guan Shi Yin Pu Sa, Namo Fo, Namo Fa, Namo Shen, Fo Guo Yu Yuan, Fo Fa Xiang Yin, Chang Le Wo Jin, Yu Yuan Fo Fa, Namo Mo He Bo Ye Bo Lo Mi Shi Da Shen Zhou, Namo Mo He Bo Ye Bo Lo Mi Shi Da Ming Zhou, Namo Mo He Bo Ye Bo Lo Mi Shi Wu Shen Zhou, Namo Mo He Bo Ye Bo Lo Mi Shi Wu Deng Deng Zhou, Namo Jin Guang Mi Mi Fo, Fa Zhang Fo, Shi Zhe Ho Shen Zhu Yu Wang Fo, Fo Gao Xu Mi Deng Wang Fo, Fa Fu Fo, Jin Gang Chang Shi Zhe Yu Xi Fo, Bao Sheng Fo, Shen Tong Fo, Yao Shi Liu Li Guang Wang Fo, Pu Guang Gong De Shan Wang Fo, Shen Zhu Gong De Bao Wang Fo, Guo Qu Qi Fo, Wei Lai Xian Jie Qian Fo, Qian Wu Bai Fo, Wan Wu Qian Fo, Wu Bai Hua Sheng Fo, Bai Yi Jin Gang Zhang Fo, Ding Guang Fo, Liu Fang Liu Fo Ming Hao, Dong Fang Bao Guang Yue Dian Yue Miao Zun Yin Wang Fo, Nan Fang Su Gen Hua Wang Fo, Xi Fang Zhao Wang Shen Tong Yan Hua Wang Fo, Bei Fang Yue Dian Qing Jing Fo, Shang Fang Wu Su Jing Jing Bao Shou Fo, Xia Fang Shen Ji Yue Yin Wang Fo, Wu Liang Zhu Fo, Do Bao Fo, Shi Jia Mo Ni Fo, Mi Le Fo, A Chu Fo, Mi To Fo, Zong Yang Yi Qie Zong Sheng, Zai Fo Shi Jie Zong Zhe, Xin Zhu Yi Di Shang, Ji Zai Xu Hong Zhong, Zi Yau Yu Yi Qie Zong Sheng, Ge Ling An Wen Xiu Xi, 昼夜修持心肠求诵此经南无声势苦相处诸毒害南无大明观世音观明观世音高明观世音开明观世音药王菩萨药上菩萨文殊师利菩萨普贤菩萨虚空藏菩萨地藏王菩萨清凉宝山亿万菩萨普光王如来化圣菩萨念念诵此经七佛世尊即说昼夜 尼婆尼婆地求好求好地陀罗尼地尼哈那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈尼婆尼婆地求好求好地陀罗尼地尼哈那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈尼婆尼婆地求好求好地 陀罗尼地尼诃那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈尼婆尼婆地求好求好地陀罗尼地尼诃那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈尼婆尼婆地求好求好地陀罗尼地尼诃那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈 尼婆尼婆地求好求好地陀罗尼地尼诃那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈尼婆尼婆地求好求好地陀罗尼地尼诃那地毗尼尼地摩诃伽地真灵成地娑哈十方观世音一切诸菩萨誓愿救众生称名悉解脱若有智慧者殷勤为解说 但是有因缘读诵口不错诵经满千遍念念心不绝火焰不能伤刀兵力追责未入生欢喜死者变成佛莫言此事虚诸佛不忘说高往观世音能救诸苦厄临危急难中死者变成佛诸佛与不虚是故因顶力 持诵满千遍，重罪皆消灭。后福坚信者，专攻受持经，愿以此功德普及于一切。诵满一千遍，重罪皆消灭。高往观世音经中，念七遍往生咒，持咒。南无阿弥陀佛耶，哆哈迦哆耶，哆地亚他。 아미니도 보비 아미니도 세담보비 아미니도 비가난데 아미니도 비가난도 캬미니 캬캬나 쯔또 캬니 소하 남모 아미도 보예 도하갸도예 도데야타 아미니도 보비 아미니도 세담보비 아미니도 비가난데 아미니도 비가난도 캬미니 캬캬나 쯔또 캬니 소하 Namo Amito Poye, Dota Gatoye, Dode Yata, Aminito Bobby, Aminito Setam Bobby, Aminito Piganante, Aminito Piganando, Gamini Kakana, Zito Kani Soha. Namo Amito Poye, Dota Gatoye, Dode Yata, Aminito Bobby, Aminito Setam Bobby, Aminito Piganante, Aminito Piganando. Gamini kakana, zito kani soha. Namo amito poye, dota gatoye, dote yata. Aminito pobi, aminito setam pobi. Aminito piganante, aminito piganando. Gamini kakana, zito kani soha. Namo amito poye, dota gatoye, dote yata. Aminito pobi, aminito setam pobi. Aminito piganante, aminito piganando, gamini kakana, zito kani soha. Namo amito poye, doha gatoye, dode yata. Aminito pobi, aminito setam pobi. Aminito piganante, aminito piganando, gamini kakana, zito kani soha. 首节莲花童子受印观相根本传承上师大拜莲花童子三光加倍持诵 持莲花童子心咒二十一遍持咒。Om Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hom Om 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 Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hom 疏解准提佛母根本印
Basic mudra.
先观空
First empty your mind.
念观空咒 Om Sopava Sutta Sarvata Ma Sopava Sutto Hang Om Sopava Sutta Sarvata Ma Sopava Sutto Hang Om Sopava Sutta Sarvata Ma Sopava Sutto Hang观想，虚空中有蓝色的月轮，月轮中有白色种子自准自放浅黄色光。月轮中准自旋转，化为浅黄色的准提佛母，是。三目十八倍的大佛母戴宝冠，宝冠中有一化佛，佛母背带璎珞白色的天衣，十八倍值多样法器，由图之右顺时针而下是如意宝床。莲花冠锁轮罗宝瓶波叶切宝曼根本印金刚杵钩乐府天妙果素珠智慧剑施无畏印根本印是双手共有十八手准提佛母身黄白色三目十八倍戴化佛宝冠庄严地出现在密宗行者之对面空中而住观想准提佛母的天心之眼放射一道极强烈的白光照灌入行者的天窍使自己的全身清净纯白在观想准提佛母的天心第三眼强烈地照射自己的天心行者全身清净光明再来观想自己心轮开放成为一朵莲花莲花心中有月轮月轮中心有种子字准字观想准字放光摄照准提佛母进入中脉坐于心中莲台一弹指间自己与准提佛母融合成一无二分别 持准提佛母心咒108遍，先做念珠观想。
We said Cundi Bodhisattva 108 times first perform mala visualization.
持咒。Om Jali Juli Jun Ti Soha Om 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 Jali Juli Jun Ti Soha Jali Juli Jun Ti Soha Om 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 Jani Juni 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 Jun Ti Soha Zuo Jiu Jie Fo Feng Yu San Mo Di 加持八大本尊心咒及念佛 Om Amitayase Om Mani Padme Hum Om Panamo Lintolin Soha Om Hahaha Wei Samaye Soha Om Jali Juli Junti Soha Om Jambhala Chalang Chalaye Soha Om Ahom Beja Guru Pema Siddhi Hum Se Om Ahom Guru Pe Aha Sasamaha Lian-Sheng Siddhi Hum Deyata Om Bekatsuya Bekatsuya Maha Bekatsuya Naja Samo Katehe Soha Namo 36万亿 同名同号 阿弥陀佛 Namo 36万亿 同名同号 阿弥陀佛 Namo 36万亿 同名同号 阿弥陀佛 持除瘟疫度母心咒21遍 持咒 Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha Om Dada Dudada Dura Namo Hara Hara Hum Hara Soha
请大家起念请佛注释起愿文 具德妙善圣尊秘密祖十方世界佛刹成宿佛大悲有情海会众菩萨护教金刚空行前顶立世间三毒炽盛夜漫漫身心摧折轮回苦无休圣尊命念降生度迷情三宝于是微光护群生 圆天福田所依金刚身受戒传法灌顶次息地佛子祈请注释转法轮离乐无量无尽众生界恭送长寿佛心咒108遍回向师尊健康长寿
持咒 Om Amaroni Juvandiye Soha 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 Om Amaroni Juvandiye Soha
Om Amaloni Zuan Diye Soha. 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 Om Amaroni 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 Zuan Diye Soha.
Hui Xiang. 愿我定慧夙缘明，愿我早得第三眼，庄严本尊大净土，愿共众生成佛道，愿同念佛者同生极乐国，上报四重恩，下济三途苦，见佛了生死，如佛度一切。真佛宗众弟子。 一心祈愿，南无大准提佛母，最胜金刚，以无上妙法护佑圣尊，佛体安康，长寿自在，常住世间，灾厄退散，大乐任运，永转法轮。恭请法王圣尊莲生活佛坐众回向。
最胜金刚，大准提佛母，一心敬最胜金刚，大准提佛母，一心敬准提佛母，加持。
We pray
幽冥众,
that you
请准提佛母接引幽冥众 往生清净佛国，祈请准提佛母，赐予众等修法，习真怀殊，皆能够
成就，在修行宏光化面，能够宏光化身，也能够本尊相应，宏光化身。
祈请最胜金刚大准提佛母，以诸大佛母光明遍照，让人间得以祥和，一切逆缘退散。
affinities disappear.
瘟疫退散,
may the pandemic vanish.
新冠病毒退散,
may the coronavirus vanish.
当一切能够光明普照, 最上金刚大尊提佛母及诸大佛母光明遍照，让资粮具足，身体健康，病业退散，一切所求皆能够如愿。最胜金刚大准提佛母，天罗神、在罗神、人离难、难离身，一切灾殃化为尘，怨敌退散，瘟疫退散，病毒退散，一切逆缘退散。问。
恭念三遍拜之名咒：嗡贝扎萨多萨玛雅玛鲁巴那雅贝扎萨多德鲁巴迪查哲宗梅巴瓦苏多卡尤梅巴瓦苏波卡尤梅巴瓦阿诺兰多梅巴瓦沙尔瓦西迪梅波拉雅查沙尔瓦噶尔玛苏扎梅吉达姆西尼仁古鲁吽哈哈哈哈呵班卡文萨瓦达他嘎达贝扎玛咪门查贝扎巴瓦玛哈萨玛雅萨多阿洪佩嗡贝扎萨多萨玛雅玛努巴那雅贝扎萨多德鲁巴迪查哲宗梅巴瓦苏多卡尤梅巴瓦苏波卡尤梅巴瓦阿诺拉多梅巴瓦沙瓦西迪梅波拉雅查沙瓦噶玛苏扎梅吉达姆悉尼仁古鲁吽哈哈哈哈呵班卡文萨瓦达他嘎达贝扎玛咪门查贝兹巴瓦玛哈萨玛雅萨多阿洪佩嗡贝扎萨多萨玛雅玛鲁巴那雅贝扎萨多德鲁巴迪查哲宗梅巴瓦苏多卡尤梅巴瓦苏波卡尤梅巴瓦阿诺拉多梅巴瓦沙瓦西迪梅波拉雅查沙瓦噶玛苏扎梅吉达姆悉尼仁古鲁吽哈哈哈哈呵班卡文萨瓦达他嘎达贝扎玛咪门查贝兹巴瓦玛哈萨玛雅萨多阿洪佩。做观想大礼拜，一拜根本传承上师及十方三世一切诸佛。嗡啊吽，观想顶礼，回天心三言。二拜诸菩萨。嗡啊吽，观想顶礼，回天心三言。三拜诸护法金刚。嗡啊吽，观想顶礼，回天心三言。四平等于起手，念圆满咒：嗡布林，嗡布林，嗡布林，嗡玛尼贝咪吽。让我们以最热烈的掌声，感谢法王圣尊莲生活佛加持同修圆满吉祥。敬献哈达，请大家恭敬合掌。请释莲花九如法师代表全体弟子向法王圣尊莲生活佛请法，敬献哈达，以表最崇高敬意。 请大家一起虔诚恭敬合掌，恭请法王圣尊莲生活佛做宝贵的法语开示。
Let's pay homage to the lineage gurus. 廖明和尚,
homage to the venerable
敬礼,
廖明,
沙迦正空上师,
homage to Master Sakya正空,
十六世大宝法王, Kamapa,
homage to Kamapa,
图登大吉上师,
and homage to Master Dukta.
我们敬礼, 坛城三宝, 敬礼,
homage to the three jewels of the altar and homage to the main deity of the group practice today, Cundi Buddha Mata, Danzen Gatso, Buddha City,
all 还有网络上的同门，大家新年好！你好，大家好！爱してる，사랑해，オラミコ。 Quiero mucho. Sugoi. Ichiba. Kimochi. Jumi. Yapi. Brin brin. Konbanwa. Dajia wanan.你好，大家好。今天在西雅图是大年初二，这个从初一开始就飘雪，那么今天跟明天 都会下雪，这个雪呀，非常的白，变成银色的世界，风景是非常的好看，但是也容易出事情，所以师尊 跟师母今天就不敢开车，正在这个犹豫不决的时候，刚好佛亲跟 Andy 他开那个坦克，就是那个 马塞利面子的那个最大型的，那像坦克的那个车子来，载我们到西雅图雷藏寺，一路上都是银色世界。我们出门的时候有一个斜坡，很高的斜坡，害怕这个。 虽然是four-wheel drive的车子，但是也是。But now,
so we have a four-wheel drive, but we don't dare to drive it.
等一下回去是这个德辉上师要。So,
going home, Master De Hui will drive us back.
那明天是彩虹山庄的
And tomorrow, we are going to Rainbow Temple. And we heard that I-90 is clear. So I should go tomorrow. So we will go to the Rainbow Temple too. So we don't stop the group practice nor the Homa ceremony. But I don't dare to drive. Actually, on a snowy ground, when I just came to Seattle, America, and I saw people drive on snow, and I thought everybody else drives, so I should be able to drive too. And my car was a rear-wheel drive. It was Mercedes. So when I drove then, I turned 360 degrees. When I got out from my house, Fo Qing and Fo Qi was still young then. And there was a huge, a long slope. And I didn't
brake.
Oh, I was putting my feet on the brake, but the car was still sliding down. And there was another road. And then Lake Sammamish in front of us, but the car was still sliding. If we get to that road, then we will hit the cars, or I would fall into the lake. But good thing there was a snow hill, a huge one, so I drove the car to the snow bank. And when I hit the snow bank, how come other people can drive but not me? Because they have four-wheel drive. And they have snow tires. It's the tires for snow time, snowy days. And if it's worse, then we have to put on snow chain. But for some snow, we use snow tires. But if it's deep snow, we have to use snow chain. Or at least you have to use winter tires of all seasons and a four-wheel drive in order to drive. Like those from Southeast Asia are really excited to see snow, but for us we are scared of the snow. On the first day, it's very beautiful, silvery old, but other than the beauty, everything else is very harmful. When I was living at the Phantom Lake, and because we turned off the faucets, so we had bursting pipes. And because the landscape gardener did not put back the cover so that the cold air got onto the faucets. And then the water got frozen, and all the way in, you have to cover the outdoor faucets. Otherwise, below the freezing point, the pipes can burst. And then we had to change the carpet. So we had such incident. So although the snow is beautiful, but there's only one benefit, but lots of problems. Of course, it's good to ski, like the Snoqualmie pass. It's best to open an orthopedic clinic there. Most people break their legs. So please, Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, protect us so that it doesn't snow. To Mahajundi Buddha Mother, please protect us so that the disciples can drive safely and smoothly without any accidents. Before the Dharma teaching, let me tell a joke.
早上上班, 医院电梯积满了, 护士,
in the morning, going to work, the hospital elevators is filled with nurses.
漂亮,
and there's a young and beautiful nurse next to a doctor. And inadvertently farted. And nobody wanted to admit who let out the gas. So the farting nurse asked quietly to the doctor, "Your English is best. Can you please teach me? The English for peace, discovery, and because the doctor wanted to
peace,
to impress the nurse, so it sounds like, you know, peace, war, found. So it's in Chinese, it's like, I was the one farted. And then everybody chased the doctor out of the elevator. Now we'll do the Q&A. Homage to the Lineage Root Guru, Grandmaster. I have some questions about Vajrapani Bodhisattva Deity Yoga in the visualization of the main part. 1. All lotuses of all colors in the sky, one of them is blue with a sun disk, and on top of it a six-syllable home which transform to become a Vajra scepter. Can I visualize this Vajra scepter to be a cross scepter? If so, at its center there is a Hom syllable radiating light to subdue all Maras. The Hom syllable enters the heart of the practitioner, and the practitioner becomes Vajrapani. And could Grandmaster please elaborate on the visualization of the Hom syllable subduing all Maras and its key formula? Details and key formula. Second question. Can I use the same visualization for sleep protection, i.e. visualizing Vajrapani protector to be in union with myself, to bless, then chant mantra, and protect, so that the dream is clear and the mind is not topsy-turvy? Third question. Grandmaster taught us that offerings can be done from top to bottom. So, the rice I use for mandala offerings can be used for the rice and clothes practice to avert negativities. So can the rice used for mandala offering be used for the rice and clothes practice to avert negativities? In principle, in the Vajrapani Bodhisattva deity yoga and visualization, first, you want to purify your karma and empty your mind. And there are lotuses of all colors in the sky. On top of the blossoms, there is a sun disk, and on top of it, a seed syllable Hom, which transformed to become a Vajra scepter. At the center of the Vajra scepter, there is a Hom syllable radiating light to subdue all Maras. The Hom syllable enters the heart of the practitioner, and the practitioner becomes Vajrapani. The body is blue-black. He has one head and two arms. The right hand forms a wrathful fist, holding a Vajra scepter raised up high. The left hand forms a Vajra fist holding a hook or lasso. He wears ornaments made of mixed jewels and snakes and tiger skin skirt. His right leg is bent and left leg straight. He is abiding amid a blazing fire prajna light. The Hom syllable in our heart radiates light to invoke the wisdom Vajrapani and the empowering five Buddhas, and all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas descend. Cha Hom Ban Ho. Enter Samadhi and be in union. Chant the mantra Hom Becha Bani Hom Pe thousands of times. Enter Samadhi. That's the explanation. And this person asks, a single scepter So, a single scepter becomes the cross scepter. Is that allowed? For me, no difference at all.
Can you imagine?
The single scepter, the five-prong scepter, three-prong scepter, cross scepter, all can subdue the Maharas. In the sadhana, and what Grandmaster wrote is the single five-prong ledger scepter, which is like this. At the center, there is a home syllable. Asked by Lianhua Minhong from Singapore. So that's a cross scepter. So he likes to visualize this cross scepter with home at the center. The five-prong single scepter versus the five-prong cross scepter. Is it allowed? He asked me. What do you think? Our Tripura disciples are inventors. When I say Vajra scepter, single scepter, they want cross scepter. Are you an inventor? He invented this kind. And this kind, three-prong Vajra scepter. This is Japanese. It's open at the top. And the Tibetan ones are closed. This are actually weapons or arms used in ancient India. Because Buddhism spread originally from India, they use Vajra scepter. This one is three-pronged. This is Tibetan version, it's closed. And Japanese Tantrayana uses the opened scepter. In my personal opinion, it's up to you. Because the single scepter can also subdue the Maharas. Three-prong, five-prong, cross-vajra scepters can all subdue the Maharas. But one point to remember, that the visualized Vajrapani always carry the Tibetan version of the five-prong single enclosed Vajra scepter, like this. Vajrapani always holds this kind. If Vajrapani Bodhisattva holds this kind of cross scepter and forming the wrathful mudra, then you have to visualize like that. It's a small issue. It's up to you. It's okay if you want to. And I have reiterated the details. And the key formula is to put your heart in it. And to be attentive. Can I use the same visualization for sleep protection? Which is visualize the union of myself with Vajrapani, chant mantra and protect the dream so that it's clear and the mind is not topsy-turvy. You're inventing again. So you use it in your sleep and dream protection. It's up to you. If you can visualize that way and it's beneficial to you, the dream is clear, the mind is not topsy-turvy, then it's up to you.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
我们这个佛教里面有所谓的
In Buddhism, there is the so-called
随顺
just go with the flow. just
好的，这个都是可以小事
Just go with it, and now just go with go ahead.
共品可以上供了之后
And Grandmaster taught us that offerings can be done from top to bottom. So can the rice used for mandala offering be used for the rice and clothes offering? Your invention again. Are you so poor? So the rice you use for the mandala plate, then you use it for the rice and clothes practice to avert negativities. Can I say it's up to you for this? You know, a lot of thing is if you just follow, go with the flow and let it be and do whatever you want, and at the lastly, it's going to be very very disorderly, very negligent. So if you go for spiritual consultation, the minimum you have to bring offerings, because you're asking the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, you should at least bring some offerings, because they borrow Grandmaster's mouth to tell you. So you have to buy and bring offerings, that's the rule. So before you go into the spiritual consultation room, you have to bring offerings with respect to the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas before you ask questions. The key is not that you ask any time you see Grandmaster. They never bring anything, no offerings for the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, and they have questions to ask. And they ask anywhere, in the garage, or whenever Grandmasters just get off the car, and then said, oh, it's inaccurate. But because you did not follow the rules, you did not follow the ethics, quote-unquote. Because you're asking the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, you have to make an offering. So Grandmaster has to quiet his mind. It's not that I just got off the car and I haven't even quieted down. My heart was still beating, and all of a sudden you ask something. And of course, whatever you say, I say fine, fine. Then of course, it's not accurate. Because you do it haphazardly, of course I answer haphazardly. If you so casual, I'm also very casual. And you don't respect the Buddhas or Bodhisattvas, and you don't even bring offerings, and you don't even give any offering to me, no red pocket for me. then how could it be accurate? Of course. You're so careless about it. So in the least, you have to go by the rules. So the rice for offering mandala, then of course that's rice for mandala offering. Can't you use a fresh rice for the rice and clothes practice? It's just a small bowl of rice. Can't you afford that? That's too much. Oh my God. I can let you follow your wishes. Or we can just go with the flow of the karma or affinity, but it cannot be too negligent and careless and casual. Then that would be the end of it. You have to know. So, Lianhua Minghong from Singapore, you're the inventor. Don't be so stingy. For the rice offering, follow the rules. And Taiwan, Lianhua Jialing. So the character. It's not the doctor Li Jialin. That sounded the same, but this is different. Guy Master. If I combine the practices of Vajrasattva and Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala, oh no, again, another inventor. If so, first I do the beginning part, then enter the mandala of Avalokitesvara body. Visualize from the mudra, chant 21 times, and then do the main part of Vajrasattva practice. From the mudra, emptying the mind, chanting the sunyata mantra, chant the 100 syllable mantra, and enter samadhi, perform visualization of oneness with Vajrasattva, then do the ending part. Is this correct? Please be compassionate to guide. So, what do you think?
金刚心菩萨,
Vajra Heart Bodhisattva, and Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala combined.
其实观音生坛城已经是
Actually, Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala is already a very good protection method. It's a very good protection method. So Avalokitesvara Bodhisattva and Vajra Heart Bodhisattva, can they be combined? I think best not to. They are of different... If you practice the Vajra Heart Bodhisattva, then you do Vajra Heart Bodhisattva. If you do Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala, then you do Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala. They don't match. No. They're not. Together. I never practiced it this way. So Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala is Avalokitesvara Bodhimandala. Yes, and you have to visualize the earth, water, fire, wind, and her eyes, her nose, her mouth, her teeth, her ears, your ears. they become the banners. There are lots of visualization. Don't combine them. Because the Avalokitesvara Bodhi Mandala is already very precious and valuable. Don't mix it up. Taiwanese students, Taiwanese and Singaporean. They like to mix things up. Mix and match. Because you in Taiwan drink all this mixed stuff. Everything is mixed up together. You know, the best way is the merit accumulation path, plus the preliminary path, plus the seeing of the path and the path of practice, plus the path of ultimate, and then the graduated stage and the perfection stage all combined together, and 100 yidams all together at once. Is that enough for you? Mixed up. Then if you do it more, then you'll become you become a wretch, a bastard. But in Chinese they use egg, you know. A mixed up egg. So chicken egg, duck egg, thousand year old egg, all mixed together. So Vajra Heart Bodhisattva is a very precious Dharma. And Avalokiteshvara Bodhi Mandala is also very precious Dharma. It's best to separate them. Just practice them one by one. From Canada, Lianhua Kailing, homage to the lineage guru.
家中的老病弟子,
a sickly family member wants to complete 100,000 prostrations before his or her death. But his or her body does not allow a full prostration on the ground. Is there a simpler version? Okay, Master, can you teach a simple method of prostration? Should we perform prostrations and great mandala offerings in front of the altar? That's the first question. A sickly family member wants to complete 100,000 prostrations before his or her death. But his or her body doesn't allow a full prostration on the ground. Can Grandmaster teach a simple version of prostration? Should we perform prostration and great mandala offering in front of the altar? Generally speaking, you perform great prostrations in front of the altar. And great offering, 100,000 times, should be done in front of the altar. That would comply with the rules. Now you understand, right? But an old and sickly family member wants to complete 100,000 prostration. You have to be empathetic. He or she wants 100,000 prostrations, but he or she is old and sick, and they cannot even kneel, and they cannot get up. I know. When they kneel, they cannot get up. I remember I went to China in the past. I went to Mount Wutai, and following me, and the one who invited me there was the first Chinese ambassador to America, Mr. Cai Zemin, the first ambassador from China to United States. He invited me to China. He was already 80 then. So when I made prostration, at Mount Wutai, and I made prostration from the top to bottom, each mountains, each temples and shrines and altars. So all the way, all of them, from the top of the mountain all the way to the bottom. But Mr. Cai Zemin just stood next to me. He did not prostrate because he was 80 and he had bad knees. He could not kneel and make prostration. And during this journey or process, there was a monk from Mount Wutai that followed me all the way. And then he told me, I've been here for over 500 years, and I never encountered anybody making prostration like this, like you. And when I heard 500 years, that would be a monster, right? Over 500 years. And he said that, I heard it. So this monk has been at Mount Wutai for over 500 years. So he must be a monster. And he followed me all the way until we were about to have our meal. So I took some renminbi to give him, and he didn't. He dejected it. He didn't want any. And then I recognized and confirmed that that monk was a reincarnation, an emanation of Manjushri Bodhisattva. At that time, I could make prostration from the peak of Mount Wutai, it's called the Bodhisattva Peak, all the way down to the bottom of the mountain. But that's nothing compared to the elder Venerable Xu Yu. He made prostrations from Mount Putuo in Zhejiang province to Mount Wutai of Shanxi province. So every three steps he made a prostration. He was so devout and sincere. I was nothing compared to him. That was truly incredible. But an old and sickly family member wants to complete 100,000 prostration before death. I have taught you, right? The simple way. When you make one prostration, you transform one of you to become 10, to become 100 of you. And then 100 of you becomes 1,000 of you. And 1,000 of you becomes 10,000 of you. And then you make the prostration. Then there would be 10,000 prostrations. And then you do it 10 times and you would meet 100,000 prostrations. That's the easiest and simplest way. First you visualize, you become three of you, and then increasing gradually to become 10, all lined up. And then moving forward, become 10 lines, so that would be 100 of you. So 10 by 10 is 100. And then you visualize 10 of that. That would be 1,000 of you. Right? And then you visualize 10 of 1,000, which is 10,000. That's the best way. So with one prostration, it becomes 10,000 prostrations, and 10 times becomes 100,000 prostrations. But Great Mandala Offering, you still have to follow. So I just secretly tell Lianhua Wang Kailing. But if you're young or healthy, you cannot use this, okay? This is only someone that's really old and the knees are already broken and they cannot move, only that you can use this method. Would you please teach me the fifth instruction for instant money practice or ways to obtain wealth?
Wang Kailin,
from Canada. I think I know her. Are you one of the five sisters?
求师尊教授马上有钱法的相应心药。
Please teach us the fifth instruction for instant money practice and ways to obtain wealth. Instant money practice is Golden Mother's Dharma. Let me tell you, pray to Golden Mother. Golden Mother is very compassionate. If you need money and you want it instantly,
有修马上有钱法的，你用尽你的心意，
you use all of your heart to pray to Golden Mother and practice the instant money Dharma practice. You use all your heart.
用尽你的心意去求瑶池金母，用尽你的心意去。
So you use all your heart to pray to Golden Mother and to practice the instant money Dharma practice. So to use all your ingenuity, your sincerity, your earnestness, or you can even cry. You know, Golden Mother also likes to cry. I know she's very compassionate. When she descends, or in the sutras, it's mentioned she often cries and shed tears. So just use all your heart and shed tears and devotedly and earnestly pray to her, ask her. That's the key formulas. And you practice the instant money Dhamma practice. It's fine to shed tears. As long as you can make Golden Mother to be compassionate or be empathetic toward you, then she will definitely help you. As a disciple of Golden Mother, I find if I go overboard in asking Golden Mother, then she will punish me. And her punishments are also quite strict and severe. But when she's very compassionate, then she's very compassionate. So she's both kind, compassionate, and also strict and severe. I've used all kinds of ways, so I truly understand Golden Mother. As long as you can make her to be compassionate toward you, then whatever you ask will be fulfilled. But if you go overboard, you're too much, and then if she wants to punish you, it's very easy. If I go overboard, it's so easy for her to punish me. She can just take me back right away, take me away. Just like that. Very simple. She can do it. So I know that she's also very strict and severe, but also very compassionate. So if you use all your hearts and earnestness and sincerity to pray to Golden Mother, and so that she feels and she generates compassion, then she will definitely help you. That's the key formula. The teacher asked Xiaoming, why are you late to class? And Xiaoming said, because there are signs on the road. So why is that related to your lateness? The teacher asked, and Xiaoming said, because it said school zone, please move slowly. Pretty good student. I only drink alcohol 3 days a week. And the policeman asked, so which 3 days? That's yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Those are very skillful answer. It's matching the questions today. When human beings old, lots of things like this. What is it like to be old? Now we know. I went to the bank in the afternoon when I was in line. There was a beautiful lady right behind me, and she asked me, "Grandpa, oh, uncle, are you coming to make deposit?" And I said, "Yeah." And the beautiful lady said, "Oh, what a coincidence, I am withdrawing some money. So you're depositing and I'm withdrawing. So why don't you just give me the money and then we don't have to get in line anymore?" And this old man, me, thought, "Oh, makes sense. No need to stay in line. This is withdrawing money and I'm depositing money." So I give her the money. Sign of old age. You know, really. After you see a beautiful lady, even when she doesn't ask for money, I would give her money. But there's a benefit to be a grandmaster.
How
come there's a beautiful lady giving me money?
每一个, 很多美女到了这里来,
on New Year, there are many beautiful ladies bring money for Grandma's Day, for Grandmaster. This is for Chinese New Year. And this beautiful lady, and that beautiful lady. They give the Grandmaster, so I get quite a bit this year then. Even when Grandmaster's old already, there's still people giving me money. Now we will talk about Lamdre. The second point, branch divisional meaning. Let's talk about the meaning of the branches as in the verse in quote on the out-of-worldly path, end quote. The out-of-worldly path refers to the path beyond the merit accumulation and preliminary path, and it starts with seeing the path. The stages of spiritual cultivation is that we start from the merit accumulation path, and then the preliminary path, and then the path of seeing, and then the path of practice, and then the ultimate path, five. Merit accumulation path, preliminary path, the path of seeing, the path of practice, and the ultimate path. From seeing the path, it's considered and on are considered the out-of-worldly path. But the merit accumulation and preliminary paths are the graduated stage. And starting from seeing the path and on are the completion stage. So the merit accumulation path and preliminary path are the worldly path. But after you see the path, then that would be the start of the out-of-worldly path. So out-of-worldly path starts with seeing the path and on.
And
merit commission and preliminary paths are considered worldly paths. For example, performing good deeds and charitable act, that's merit commission path. When we do the four preliminary practices, prostrations, mandala, fourfold refuge, four immeasurables, repentance, those are practice on the worldly path. And after these two paths, after you see the path, that's to teach you to gain enlightenment. After seeing the path, you start the outer worldly path. Why? Because after you see the path, you would know that everything in the Saha world are illusory. Everything. Yes, play of words of Chinese. They're all illusory. So, and in one phrase, unattainable. Nothing is attainable. So you have be enlightened to this unattainability. In the Heart Sutra, there's this very important statement, because there is nothing to gain, therefore Bodhisattva. And because you have realized that there is nothing to gain, you enter the path of Bodhisattvahood. Therefore, brand famous cars you have driven and you have worn brand watches, and you have worn the most expensive brand clothing, and you have the money, you have lived in the best houses, and then one day you gain enlightenment that none of those are yours. They are nothing to gain, nothing to attain. You have no more greed. It's gone. You truly have no more greed about the world. Then you start the practice on the out-of-worldly path. First, you have to be enlightened to this. Everything is transient, very short-lived. Everything in the world is transient and short-lived. And afterwards, it's gone. They're gone. There was a legislator from Taiwan that told me, the person is in heaven. His wife is in the chest of somebody else's. His money is in the bank. And the siblings are fighting for your inheritance. He told me that, and I said, oh, you have realization. But that's pretty good. If you're already in heaven, why do you care about anything in the world? Wives, wealth, children, and money, they're all just illusory. They're like smokes and in the mirror.
知分意,因,有眼因,近因,
okay, for the titles, branch divisional meaning, cause, far cause, near cause, outer star affinity, inner star affinity, fruit verification, suchness verification, A, 700 merits, B, the initial ground of the supreme seeing the path, C, merit differences, D, non-leaking, 16 bliss. And then outer verification, inner verification, and then conclusion. Talking about seeing the path, the newest book that I will start on Monday, the subtitle is The Elderly in His 70s, The Sound of the Hearts of an Elderly in His 70s. And then the title is the True Words of Seeing the Path. The True Words of Seeing the Path. That's the title. So I will talk about this seeing the path. Have you gained enlightenment? Are you enlightened? If you're enlightened, why do you care what people say to you yesterday or the day before? Or what will you answer tomorrow? No. No, no need. Just let it be. Let it go. Let it go with the affinities. Just let it be. Doesn't matter. No big deal. The Venerable Elder Guo Xian, the one who shaved my head, always said, it's okay, doesn't matter, no big deal. You don't care about anything. You don't Why do you have all these things that it's no big deal, it doesn't matter? No big deal, you don't be bothered about that. That's all words after you see the path. If today you have seen the path, the Confucius said that if you see the path in the morning, that you can die at night. You're happy to die at night. Sakyamuni Buddha, upon his enlightenment and attained Buddhahood, under the Bodhi tree, he cultivated spiritually and practiced the path, see the path, realize the path, practice the path, and attain the ultimate path. And then he spoke one statement, Nirvana. Sakyamuni Buddha wanted to enter Parinirvana, Nirvana. That's right. What Sakyamuni Buddha said was right. At that time, he already attained Buddhahood. He wanted to enter Nirvana. However, upon request by Mahabrahma, and the king of Trayatrimsa's request to turn the Dharma wheel for three turns. He wanted to enter Nirvana again, and then Manjushri Bodhisattva descended and said, Buddha, why don't you continue to turn the Dharma wheel again? And Sakyamuni Buddha replied, have I turned the Dharma wheel? And When Manjushri Bodhisattva heard that, immediately he comprehended. So Sakyamuni Buddha turned the Dharma wheel three times, but actually he never did. And Manjushri Bodhisattva was an enlightened one. Upon hearing that, he understood. So this was upon seeing the path, upon enlightenment. Was that Confucius that said that when you see the path in the morning, you can die at night? You comprehend in the morning, then at night you can go. I also experienced this, the same phenomena. I can go anytime. It's fine. It's all good. It's all fine. Nothing to regret. I have no regret whatsoever. You know, you have comprehended, and you know, why do I want to stay in the human world, turning the Dharma wheel? See, the Buddha said, even after turning the Dharma wheel three times, it's not considered turning the Dharma wheel. I'm giving Dharma teaching, it's not Dharma giving Dharma teaching. This is fine. So, after seeing the path, you enter the initial ground of Bodhisattvahood, and that's the out-of-worldly path. That's all for today. Om Mani Padme Hum.
非常感谢法王圣尊莲生活佛宝贵的法语开示
2021 Sunday at 3 p.m. His Holiness will be at the Rainbow Temple to preside over the annual Spring Blessing Ceremony of Thousand Eyes, Thousand Arms, Avalokitesvara, Bodhisattva, Homa Fire Offering Ceremony, and confer the corresponding empowerments. For details,
恭请法王圣尊莲生活佛加持大悲咒水，即为佛像开光。
We are inviting His Holiness to consecrate Buddha images and to bless the great compassion holy water. This ends the English meditation today. Thank you very much. Om Guru Lian-Sheng Si Ti Hung.
请大家起立坐大礼拜，礼拜根本传承上师及十方三世一切诸佛，嗡啊吽。二拜诸菩萨，嗡啊吽。
同修会圆满吉祥结束了，非常感恩师尊的大加持，感谢师母诸位仁波切诸位上师、教授师法师同们善信大德的护持，谢谢大家，阿弥陀佛。网络直播到此结束，感谢大家的收看。With now conclude this live broadcast. Thank you for viewing.
我们现在恭请师尊加持大家，请大家保持60的距离，谢谢。